Okay, so weird because it was working on my end. Welcome back. Thank you. Okay, sorry about that, everybody. So did anyone catch any of the warm up? No. Wow. Oh my God. Okay.
It was so strange.
Just the sitting still.
Sitting still. Okay.
Some of us were doing our own warm up.
Okay. I'm gonna mute you all again so we can just jump into this. I'm sorry about that, everybody. I'm also, yeah. Oh, I'm getting ready to chew Zoom out. My patience is running very thin. Yeah, cool. Thanks, Sir Don. Okay. All right. Okay, we'll do a quicker version. So, go ahead and close your eyes. Okay, and I just want you to feel supported by the floor or whatever surface you're on right now. So, feeling supported by your chair or by your feet on the floor. And then just finding that body scan, we're going to work from the bottom all the way to the top. Moving through your feet, your legs and your knees. Your thighs and hips. Noticing how your whole back is feeling, how your chest is feeling, your shoulders and your neck. Okay, go ahead and set your intention for class today. We'll take one more inhale, one more exhale, and we'll open the eyes. Okay. We're going to start with some neck movement. So I just want you to do a few neck circles coming around. Yeah, nice and slow and easy. For those of you that have hardware in your neck, you can do this more from your ribs. Noticing if there's any tight areas for you today. We'll switch direction. And then just being mindful to not throw the head back. It's just a tilt of the head when it goes back. Okay, and then coming back to the center. And then we're gonna do this is what I call pigeon head. So as if your head was moving like a pigeon, you're gonna jut your chin forward and then give yourself a double chin. Forward, back, forward, back, forward, back. And once you get the hang of it, it's kind of hard to talk and do this one. Once you get the hang of it, can you pick up the speed? Forward, back. These are movements to just help mobilize all of the joints in your neck, your cervical vertebra, and some of the muscles in there. Yeah. Forward, back. There we go. And we're going to come to the center. We're going to do a similar movement, but side to side. So it's a glide of the head to the left and a glide of the head to the right. So think of chin, bottom of your chin still staying parallel with the floor. This one can definitely be harder. And just gliding the neck one way and then the other. Yeah, this one is harder for people, huh? Okay, good. And relax. Let's bring the hands up towards the sky. Interlace the fingers if you can. Take an articulating roll down. Just take one breath at the bottom and then roll yourself back up. Good. I'm gonna have you rotate to the left. You're gonna roll down, so right ribs should be open, and you're gonna pause here. Okay, I want you to take a big inhale into the right ribs. And then just a nice passive exhale. Same thing a couple more times. Big inhale. Passive exhale. Just do one more like that. Big inhale. Passive exhale and roll yourself back up all the way to the center. Rotate to the right. Articulate down. Same thing on this side. Big inhale into the left ribs now. And then passive exhale. Big inhale. And passive exhale. Last one, big inhale. Passive exhale and roll yourself back up. Good, bringing the arms down, open up the chest, pull the chest and the heart forward. And then let go, go ahead and shake out your hands and your shoulders. Okay, we're gonna do a bit of a longer warm up with the bands, and I'm gonna go a few minutes over today. So if you can stay with me, then stay with me, but we'll make up for the lost time here. If you've got a TheraBand, give yourself enough space to start. So my hands are a little bit wider than hip distance apart, so not too much resistance on the band. This also depends how much resistance your band is. Yeah. Okay, so we're just gonna come into an overhead arm raise, bringing that band overhead. If you're able to, and this depends if you have a chair behind you, but bringing your arms all the way over, back, and behind you. Yeah, so that TheraBand is now touching the top of my, kind of the middle part of my waist. And then bringing it up and over and letting the band rest on my lap. Yeah, we're just gonna do that a few times. Up and over behind me, up and over in front of me. And if it's really hard for you to get your hands behind you, whether that's from the shoulder mobility or the kind of band you're using, then you're just gonna stay with an overhead arm raise. Yeah, and for those of you that are able to bring your hands all the way behind you, I just want you to think of opening up the chest. As the arms go back behind you, maybe even taking an inhale into that space before bringing the arms back forward. Okay, so for those of you that can bring your arms all the way up and over, you're gonna leave your hands behind you. Everyone else, you can leave your arms up overhead. And you're gonna take a side bend to your left. Yeah, so chest is still pulling forward, and then a side bend to your right. And if you've got, yeah, and I just want you to go back and forth between that side bend left and side bend right. If you've got the band behind your back right now, you can give the band a little bit of a tug to give you more of a stretch through the front. Okay, so as I side bend to the right, I'm giving my left arm a bit of a tug, and then vice versa on the other side, if that's there for you and if you're able to. Feels really good on your lats and on your chest. Yeah, let's just do one more. And then we'll come back to the center, bringing the band up and over to the front. Good, go and roll the shoulders out a little bit. Okay, we're just gonna do some book openers from here. Again, I don't want a ton of resistance, so I'm gonna be pretty generous. My hands are quite a bit wider than my shoulder distance. And I'm gonna turn and rotate to my left. And I'm trying to pull my two hands as far away from each other as I can. And then I slowly come back to the center. Yep. And then rotating to the right, pulling those two arms away from each other, create some tension on the band, and then coming back to the center. Remember, the closer your hands are towards each other, the more challenging it becomes. So you can choose how hard you want to make this one. I might shorten mine a little bit now. And just rotating to the left and to the right. Remember, with any band exercises that you do, you control the band. The band doesn't control you. Okay, so not letting the band snap your arms together. You control the band. Let's do two more here. And last one. Okay, good. And then we'll let the band down. We'll shake the shoulders out. Roll the shoulders out one more time. Okay, if you're able to change positions just slightly with your hands, we're gonna do a little bit of external rotation for your rotator cuff. My palms are facing up. I have the band wrapped around your hands, whatever's easiest for you. And I'm pinching my elbows in towards my ribs. The hands slowly move away from each other. The hands slowly move back in. Okay, but palms stay facing up the whole time and elbows stay squeezing in towards the ribs. Away and in. Away and in. Yeah, and to be honest, you don't even really need a TheraBand for this one. When I'm doing shoulder prep for myself, I don't actually even use the TheraBand. I just try to see how much range of motion I can get without the TheraBand. The TheraBand is just an added challenge. You don't necessarily need it for this one. Yeah, just maybe give me 8 or so more. Just watching folks here. This is a really healthy movement for the shoulder. Okay, good. Last one. And then back to the center. Okay, we're just going to do a couple more here. So now palms are facing down, hands are a little bit wider than shoulder distance. And we're just going to do chest openers. Okay, so just pulling both arms away from each other until that TheraBand hits my chest. And then back to the center. Again, if you don't have a TheraBand, you can just be doing the same movement without it. Engaging those muscles between the shoulder blades. And then controlling the band so the hands don't snap back together. My elbows are completely straight here. If that's hard for you to do, they can be bent, that's fine. Yeah, let's do 4 more. Yeah, these kinds of movements are always nice to do right before a workout because they really all target the back muscles more. So it's nice to warm up the back and warm up the shoulders before we jump in. Yeah, awesome, nice work everyone. Okay, feel free to put that band aside. We won't need that again. We'll come into the circuit here. Let me just put my weights down. We're gonna do a 15 minute circuit, as many rounds as possible, and you'll just count the rounds here. Only 4 exercises for this one, so not too complicated. And then Sarah Dawn has posted that workout down into the chat box, so you can check that out if my board is getting hard to read. Okay, first exercise is gonna be a push-up or an overhead press. So for my seated athletes, for those of you that are able to, or it makes sense for you, if you've got like something low, like a low coffee table or a counter or a desk, you can always do push-ups off of that low of a surface. If that isn't available to you, you could always use your lap. And instead of using your back to pull you up, you're using your arms to push you up. Okay, so I'm not letting my torso do the work. I'm making my triceps and my chest and my shoulders do the work. Okay, so you've got option number 1, a push-up off of a surface, a low surface or your lap. Or you can come into an overhead press, grabbing, how many reps do I be doing this? 15, yeah, grabbing like your medium to heavy set of weights if you can. And then just coming up into a strict overhead press. Yeah. Palms facing inward, pressing directly overhead, and then returning back to the start. Yeah, you can keep practicing as I'm explaining these. Standing athletes, you have a couple of options. You too can come to a surface, like a coffee table, and you can do your push-ups there. If you're able to get down on the floor, you'll come into a quadruped. You could do a quadruped push-up. Knees below hips, wrists below shoulders. You could do a kneeling push-up where I've got a little bit more weight on my upper body. So either moving your knees back or your hands forward. And then you can do a full push-up from your foot or from your feet, from your hands and your feet, lowering down and then pressing up. And yes, I only demo one of those or I get too tired and I can't speak. You only get one of each. And can't get, yes, yeah, a wall. If you don't have a coffee table, using a wall or a closed door, if the door is trustworthy, you can do that also. Okay, you're doing 15 of those. 15 of those total. Second exercise is going to be figure eights. So grab your heavier set of weight. I'm just gonna hold on to both of mine. And you're doing a horizontal figure eight, also known as an infinity sign. So these kind of turn into a wood chop movement. That's the point. Yeah, gosh, I love how everyone's already doing this. Okay, so bringing the arms up and then swooping through the center, bringing the arms up and around, swooping through the center. And you're just coming into a rhythm with these ones, swooping down, pulling up, swooping down, pulling up. Okay, so it's controlled, but you're using the momentum from the swoop to bring you into the other part, the rounded part of the figure eight. Yeah, I love it. Nice, everybody.
Do we do any squatting if we can?
Yes. Yes. Did I write that? Oh, I didn't write that. Yeah. For the figure eights, you're going to add a squat. Yeah. Thanks for reminding me, Peter. Yeah. For standing athletes, you're going to be doing the same thing, but you're adding a squat as you find that swoop down, the swooping down part of the figure eight. Yeah. Yeah. So it really kind of turns in like you're chopping wood to the left, you're chopping wood to the right, but keep that horizontal figure eight movement. You're doing 20 of those total. I'm counting these a little funky today. Down to the left is one, down to the right is two, down to the left is three, down to the right is four, okay? So count each side as one rep. Left one, right two, left three, right four. Okay, third exercise is going to be a high pull for my seated athletes. So arms either resting down on the lap towards the knees or just resting down towards the ground. And then you're gonna do a high pull. So elbows and wrists come to almost the same height there, and then letting the wrists go back down. Yeah, so we're targeting the muscles more in the upper back as opposed to the mid back when we do this high pull. Okay, but remember, if you're able to, I want elbows lifted with wrists. So it's not just the wrists, it's elbows with wrists. There we go, that's better, yeah. Okay, it's almost like you're dragging the weights up the front of your body, dragging the weights back down, dragging up, dragging down. So the weights stay on the same vertical line. My standing athletes, instead of that high row, you're going to be coming into a backwards lunge. So holding on to your weights, stepping 1 foot back into a backward lunge, lowering down. Remember, the knee does not have to touch the floor. It can come right above the floor. And then stepping the feet back together. Lower down into a lunge, step back together. You want to lower down into a lunge where your knees and your hips come to about a 90-degree angle. You're doing 14 of those total. Fourth and final exercise is going to be punches for my seated athletes, my all-time favorites. Okay, so remember, thumbs over the wrists if you can. Punching right, left, like you've got a bag in front of you. Moving quick, rotating from the torso. So remember, it's not just the arms moving, it's the whole body twisting to throw each punch. There we go, yeah. I see some people really reaching for it, that's awesome. Yeah. Okay, and then standing athletes are gonna be doing quick feet. So right foot in front of the left. You can either do quick stepping, right forward, left forward, right back, left back, or you can do more of a hop in between each run. Simultaneously switching the feet back and forth. 30 of those on each side. Okay, so one more time. Push-ups, overhead press for 15 total. Figure eights, 20 total. high pull or backward lunge for 14 total, punches or quick feet for 30 on each side. Okay, I'm gonna start you off. I'm gonna do the first couple exercises with you and then I'll get the music going just to make sure we're all good. And we're gonna go a few minutes over today because we had some technical difficulties in the beginning. So if you can hang around till the end, we will be here. Okay, so you are starting with push-ups or overhead press for 15 and then moving into your figure eights for 20. Okay, here we go. 15 minutes on the clock. Remember how many rounds you get through. On your marks, get set and go. Remember, if you're doing the push-ups, see if you can find an inhale to lower down and then an exhale to press back up. And then from the push-ups, you'll go right into those figure eights. Trying to find a good rhythm for these ones. There you go. Nice, everybody. I get some music going here.
Trying to start some. I know I'm young, but can you hear that? Telling everyone to kick rocks. A couple rounds of the miscall. I'm falling down and I'm holding it all by a thread now. No, I ain't perfect. Never said I was perfect. And I'm putting it all on a prayer now. No, I ain't perfect. Never said I was perfect. This ain't my finest hour. Might see my flaws today. My words are out of order. Maybe my drinks to blame. Empty in all my pockets till I don't feel a thing. This ain't my finest hour. This ain't my finest hour. My finest.
You're 5 minutes in, everyone. 10 minutes left. 10 minutes left.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it, so don't stop.
Nine minutes in, 6 minutes left. 6 minutes left. We'll be right back. You have 2 minutes left. 2 minutes left. See if you can push yourself. On top of the world, I'm about to lose control. Let it know tomorrow. Come and let the feeling go. All over the world, there's a fever taking hold. Let it know tomorrow. Come and let the feeling go. A mí me gusta como tú te mueves. En esta vida loca y al besar tu boca como tú no hay otra. Adoro como tú a mí me lo haces. Vamos matando en mi casa, nos vemos en la calle. No romantic. Put your hands up, reach for the ceiling. Hands up, stand up, head to the sky. Chica, chico, baila conmigo.
Ponerte a disfrutar, solo con tocarla ella se desacata. Ando en la calle buscando el dinero para gastar. De Santo Domingo a Barcelona te llevo. Si tú quieres yo te llevo. Y si te montas yo te llevo. Baila conmigo y te llevo.
Chica, chico, baila conmigo.
Okay, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Ooh-wee. Nice work, everybody. Make sure that's out of the way. Awesome. Feel free to grab some water and then type into the chat box how many rounds you got. Yeah, that was a hard one. It was kind of a fast-paced one. Wow, Kenzie with 8. Nice work, Kenzie. Yeah, you can also unmute yourself if that's easier. Catherine with 7 rounds. Nice work, Catherine. Cindy with 5.
2.5.
2.5. Nice, Peter. Claudia with 3.5.
I did 4. Patty.
Patty, awesome. Patty. Nice work, Patty. Hey, it's good to see you.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Awesome. The VA, 6 rounds with 6 vets and 2 staff. Awesome. Nice work, all of you. As always, it's good to have you. Tony with 4 rounds, and do you have some time for some banjo music? Maybe at the end, maybe that will be our wind down. But get your banjo ready, Tony. Yeah. Awesome. Okay, well, feel free to keep sharing. I'm just gonna mute everybody one more time, and if I miss any, I'll catch them at the end of class here. Cool, okay. Alrighty, so let's come back to a grounded position. Okay, and this time if you're able to, either fingers interlaced or not, but you're gonna put your hands behind your head, so kind of on the back of your neck, either fingers interlaced or not. Yeah, and then you're gonna look down. And as you look down, I just want you to slide your hands up to the base of your skull, just to give a little bit of extra stretch there. And then back to the center. And then pull the elbows away from each other to open up the chest as much as you can. And then try to make your elbows kiss each other and round your back and get small. Open the elbows, lift the chest. Take an inhale. And then exhale, get small. Try to touch the two elbows together. A few more times. Inhale, lift, spread the elbows away. And then get small, elbows come together. Last one. Lift, elbows away. And then get small. Good, and then come back to the center. We can release the hands, giving the hands a shake, the arms a shake. Maybe let your breath go. Okay. Awesome, we'll settle back down. We'll close the eyes. And again, just let whatever surface that you're on hold you. So let yourself be heavy, either down through your chair or down through the floor. And then finding that same body scan from our feet to our head. Noticing your feet and your ankles, your calves and knees, thighs and hips, your low back, mid back, and upper back. How's your chest feel? How does your neck feel? And then go ahead and think of one thing you're grateful for today. We'll take one more inhale, one more exhale, and we'll open the eyes. Awesome. Thank you so much for joining again today, everybody. I so appreciate your patience when we have technical difficulties. So yes, thank you for hanging in there. I go ahead and stop the recording.